Gold Saucer is one of the best way to spend some chill quality time in Final Fantasy XIV, and in this video you'll learn just how easy it is to make it profitable as well. The currency related to Gold Saucer activities is MGP, meaning Manderville Gold Saucer Point, and that's what you'll be wanting to get yourself some gorgeous mounts, minions and other goodies. So if you'd like to be wealthy enough to ride a cactus, a stunning black car or a cool looking turtle among other things in no time, stay tuned. My name is Ivona from MomsDen.com, and if this is your first time around here, subbing is a good idea. I do simple MMO guides for classes, raids, and collectibles you'll love if you enjoy getting easy in-game wins in no time. I also live stream Final Fantasy XIV on this channel quite a bit, so if you enjoy a lovely community and good times, feel free to drop by, we'd love to have you. The first and most important thing to pay attention to is your challenge log, which contains tasks that reset once a week, on Tuesdays to be exact. You'll unlock your challenge log once you're level 15 and have completed the Call of the Sea quest. Then go to Limsa Liminza Upper Decks and find the quest Rising to the Challenge, which will unlock this feature for you. When it comes to the Gold Saucer challenges, you'll notice that they award a bunch of MGP. And the more features you unlock inside of the Gold Saucer, the more weekly quests you'll have to complete, which is more opportunities for income. When it comes to challenge log activities, not all of them are profitable as standalone features. For example, the mini games, but if you complete 3 of them a week, you get 1000 MGP just like that. And another 1.5k for getting 100 MGP from the mini games. You'll also get quite a bit from participating in gates, which are like fates but for the Gold Saucer, and quite a bit for participation in the Chocobo races. You can just enter 20 of them for 13k MGP a week, but in order to actually be winning, you'll need to dedicate some time for their breeding and development, but more on that in another video. Then you've got the Triple Triad Wins, which is the Gold Saucer's card game and my personal favorite, as the game is easy to learn and insanely addictive once you get into it. The weekly challenge log is very easy, as all you need to do is queue matches and one open tournament a week, and there's a lot of MGP to be made from it. Once you've unlocked Lord of Verminion, which is where you battle your own minions against the enemy team, you'll easily be able to earn plenty of MGP just by participating in it a few times a week, and the same goes for Mahjong. I'm just mentioning all these features without getting into them deeply, because in the rest of the video, I'll talk more about the ones you should be doing past the challenge log, and I'll be doing a series of guides on how to master each one of these features, so stay tuned for that. One of the best ways to try and snatch a bunch of MGP is the daily lottery game called Mini Cagpot. This is a chance game where your main goal is to reveal numbers on a 3x3 board and get the sum of 6 in a selected row. You'll have one number on the board revealed for you, and you want to carefully click around the board 3 times and try to determine where the winning row is. In other words, you're trying to get a 1-2-3 sequence, which equals 6 in a sum, but if you don't think that's on your board, try going for 7-8-9, as the sum of it is 24, which will award you with 3.6k MGP. You can participate in 3 of those a day, and even if you hit the jackpot once, it can still happen to you again on the same day. And I've confirmed that many times over. The vendor is very easy to find. It's in the middle circle at the entrance square, which is the blue area of your map, and you simply cannot miss it. Another super profitable endeavor is the Jumbo Cagpot, and this is your big weekly lottery and a chance to win a million MGP as a first prize and some sweet, sweet consolation ones as well. You can buy 3 tickets on a weekly basis, and all you need to do is fill out a 4-digit number to enter for each one. Every Saturday there is a drawing, and you have a week to see if you've been lucky enough to win a million MGP. Even if you aren't, you're still getting about 1k MGP just for trying and failing at all the numbers, so definitely go out there and do it. If you're looking for the Jumbo Cagpot vendor, she's over at the Cagpot Square behind the golden counter and very hard to miss. There's one more extremely profitable way of getting MGPs, and that's the Triple Triad Open Tournament. I already briefly mentioned this in the challenge log, as you get quite a bit of MGP for just participating in one, but if you're any good at the Triple Triad, you can win a lot more. There's an open tournament every odd hour, and you don't even need any of your cards for it, as this is a pre-made draft. You can even click on the recommended button and try to win with a suggested set of cards, which usually works out very well. The winning prizes are a good time investment, and by growing your collection from the loot that you'll get ahead in the tournaments, you can set yourself up for winning even more MGP in the future. If you are a tournament person, you can step up your MGP grind game and get even more out of Triple Triad fun by participating in the weekly tournaments. They happen every couple of weeks and run for a full week. Your goal is to achieve a ranking through playing 20 matches versus either other people or the NPCs in the Battle Hall, excluding the Overseer for some reason. In this mode, you also have a recommended button if you feel particularly clueless, but the deck is built from your own cards, so here's the reason to start collecting them. If you're interested in this feature, head over to the tournament board in the card area of the Gold Saucer and talk to the NPC that'll sign you up for the weekly. From there, queue for the Battle Hall in your duty finder, talk to the hall assistant in there, and ask to get signed up for the tournament matchmaking. It's as easy as that. Another cool feature of the Gold Saucer is the weekly fashion report. You'll unlock it by doing the Passion for Fashion quest from Lewina, and she'll forward you to the Masked Rose, who will once a week have a particular theme that you'll need to fulfill in order to get a good fashion review. Basically, you'll need to get some gear or dye your existing one and present yourself to the Rose upon doing so. Scoring an 80 out of 100 will award you with a whopping 60k MGP a week, and by getting a score of 100, you'll also obtain the Fashion Leader title. You don't have to trouble yourself with finding the correct items every week, as the Final Fantasy subreddit always has a weekly topic where appropriate items are listed, along with their sources, and if you're more of a social media person, I encourage you to follow Kayoku Star on Twitter, who diligently publishes fashion reports every week, along with all the items you need for the perfect score. The link to the Twitter page is in the description. As you can tell, I haven't been focusing on the minigames too much, as they're not a big of a deal in terms of how much MGP they award. However, if you're looking for something to do during your dungeon queues, this is absolutely something you could be spending your time on, as over time, these tiny rewards from minigames actually pile up. There are plenty of them, and they're all across Gold Saucer, so just take your pick and go for it. If you're level 60, there's an interesting feature that you may be interested in case you're up for a bit of RNG, Dungeons and Trials. You can get the Wondrous Tales from Clo Aliapach in Idleshire. It's kind of a tic-tac-toe game where you've got a series of randomized trials and dungeons to complete and get seals. This feature resets every Tuesday, and you've got to collect at least 9 seals out of 16 to complete the journal, as well as align 4 of them diagonally, horizontally, or vertically. I won't get into any specifics, as you'll discover them on your own if you're into it, but you can easily go into the dungeons unsynced and finish the first row for like 30k MGP and a lot more for the rest. There are some NPCs that are very much worth visiting and engaging into Triple Triad matches with outside of the Gold Saucer, and one of them is the Indolent Imperial in Mordona, and I'll leave the coordinates to this dude in the description of the video. If you win, you'll be getting 120 MGPs per win, and he also has a 3% chance to drop the Geist von Belsar card that you can actually sell for 1.k MGP. Not bad. If you've been leveling your Grand Company ranks and have the Squadron feature available, you can send them out on missions and receive an item called the Gold Saucer VIP card. This is a consumable that will give you a 2-hour buff, increasing the amount of MGP you'll get from all the Gold Saucer related activities, except for the challenge log rewards. It's a very nice thing to use before knowing you're gonna spend quite a bit of time in the casino and possibly swim in the MGPs. It's a good idea to save the card for when you're about to open your Catpot tickets, as this bad boy applies for them too. That's not the end to the buffs when it comes to MGP, as you can get a 24-hour buff from your free company actions that increases your MGP income by either 5 or 10%, depending on your free company's rank. So be sure to drop by the Quartermaster to check out and see if it's available. If you're watching this video in the summer, you might be in luck, because there's a seasonal event called Make It Rain that'll get your MGP earnings boosted by 50%, and for 2021, that begins on July the 19th. A detailed guide on the event should be on the channel in a couple of days from now, so stay tuned or check out the other videos in the Gold Saucer playlist to see if it's there. That's pretty much it when it comes to successfully farming MGP this year and probably for the foreseeable future. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions or methods of your own, and if you haven't subbed to the channel yet, now is a good time to do that. Thank you ever so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Good luck and bye bye.